Good morning, good afternoon, or good evening, whenever you're watching this video. Please like this video for me, if you would. Thank you to my subscribers who are still holding on with me while I go through some processes here at home. I thank you guys. I thank you for my new subscribers who've come and who joined my channel. I thank you. And I hope in the near future I'll be able to put out some content that you guys will be proud of. Or at least come to and just kind of listen to me. It's about 15 to 3 in the morning and I couldn't sleep because something bothered me that somebody had written, well, three people had written on one of my videos, I think, regarding my father. And I found out from someone else on YouTube, from a friend, I guess you can say, that these people are from, is it Babe Nation and Club Chat? Or whatever. So I'm going to get straight to the point on this one. The thing that amazes me about people in general, if you say you hate on somebody, or if you don't like somebody, if you're not interested in that individual, why do you watch that individual? And see, that's the difference, I guess, in me. If it's somebody that I don't really care for, or like the content, or like the message they're giving, then I don't watch it. I honestly don't. People say they say that. A lot of us say that all the time, but in all honesty, I don't. I don't watch it. Why? If it bothers me. If it bothers my spirit or bothers something with me, why would I take the time out of my day to watch it? So I don't. So, you know, you do have people who will tell you things that are being said or things that are being done against you, or, you know, whichever way, negative or positive, and you want to go and see for yourself, then if you want to say that I watch it, I watch it then if it's there. In this case, though, there are comments that were left on my videos regarding my father. And one of them said, in essence, to, I need to let it go, get over it. And I can't remember what the other two were in reference to, because it was something regarding my father's death and me being, I don't know if it's referencing me to being to cloud chasing or money chasing or something of that nature, and I'm no better than some other people. I don't have to really defend myself in certain ways, because if you go to my videos, they basically tell off on themselves. I never asked anyone for a Cash App, or I never came on here, even during my darkest moments when I came on YouTube and was visiting other people's chats or something and spoke to the people, they would ask how am I doing. I would tell them, you know, I'm okay. You know, I didn't go into moments when I have those moments when I break down, because I do miss my father. I didn't go to into the reality of how I truly felt, because I didn't want people to think I was seeking compassion, begging for sympathy. It wasn't like nothing like that at all. The reason I shared my father's journey with you guys is because he's a part of my life, and I wanted to share that aspect of my life with you. And in many ways, I have to say that it really did help me. While going through with his illness and with his sickness and with his dementia, being able to just really get on here and talk about it sometimes and just share some pictures with you guys, you know, show my father. I was proud of my daddy. I loved him. And I wanted to share him with you guys, even at his lowest point. I still want to share that experience with you when I was going through, because you're my subscribers and I'm here on YouTube. And the thing is, was to basically just share me with you. So there was no other ulterior motive or any purpose outside of that. And the thing that was so funny to me, I thought, a person, and I'm not saying I'm better than anybody or more than anybody, but a person of my caliber wouldn't think that way. My mind is not deviant to the point where I'm thinking, what can I get out of this? Or who can I shade with that? Or who can I get a come up on with this? See, my mind doesn't work like that. My mind was at the point of wanting to share me and my life experiences. Though it's not as tumultuous as many, it's still my life and my life experiences. And I thank God it's not as tumultuous as many people. I really do, because there's no way I could have handled all that along with my dad. But forgive me, I'm out of breath. I've been trying to get some things done here at the house. I'm putting the house up for sale, so there's a lot of things I have to do. But that just bothered me that people would be so evil, I guess, and so negative, even in this aspect of YouTube. You know, does that make sense? That your mindset would be so dark and still be so dark that even in somebody else's hour of grief or hour of sadness or whatever the situation may be, you would still come and try to tread upon that person's grief. It just blows my mind to think that there are people who are that devious in their everyday life, and you would sit here and you would come to somebody that you say you don't like, that you hate, that I'm clout chasing, that I'm trying to get a come up, trying to scam people out of Cash Apps, all this stuff that's being said. And I've never done any of it. I've only just been honest and open about myself and about the things I do with my father when he was alive. But I won't get into telling this person, you know, you need to let it go and get off of it and get over it and all this other type of things that these three people stated to me. I don't know if they've ever lost a loved one or anyone in their life that they love, not necessarily a loved one, but I'm just going to say that's easier said than done. And if that's where you are, then God bless you. I still won't get over here and curse you out and speak ill of you and go off on you and go on a tantrum, because that's just not who I am. Even in the midst of my grief now, and that's not for sympathy, that's just the reality of my life as it is right now, because I lost my father. But when they told me the people who were in the group that these people were in, excuse me, my sugar is off because I just ate something, I had eaten all day, then it made sense to me, because I've been saying this for months. And I told you guys, I will not take this back. I will still say this, that the people that are in relationship with those groups or that particular content creator, they are evil. And everything that comes out of them is darkness. See, that'll never change. Unless God shows me differently or something happens, they're just boing, you know, just knock me out of it. So once I sat here and thought about it, when I laid here, I'm lying in bed and thought about it, I thought, well, why would I expect anything more or less from those people? My only thing was, why come over there and leave such negative comments? When basically it has nothing to do with you, has nothing to do with the group that you're in, the people that you're involved in, or the people that you follow. So it shows me in some aspect of your living that you're not happy, that you dwell in darkness, that you thrive in darkness, that you get exhilaration from trying to step on the hurt of others. But you didn't do that to me. Even in my father's passing and dealing with the things I'm having to deal with, you still didn't get to me. Because I told you guys when I first started, it takes a lot. It really does to really get to me. So you didn't succeed. And I'm only addressing you because I want you to know that God loves you. And that even in the midst of the persona that you're trying to portray on YouTube, if that's the case, if that's what you're doing, I feel sorry for you. That you can't stand in your authentic self and just be who you are, who God created you to be, walk in that and be happy in that. That the only place that you will find happiness is trying to destroy others or to defame others, to slam others, those who are trying to be productive in their lives in this country, so to speak, that you would step on that because you have nothing better going on for yourself. That's a sad commentary. Especially with all the things that's going on in the world and everything that's going on in people's individual lives. I've been watching a lot of the videos where I do things around the house, and there's some very unhappy people here. There's some people who have unfulfilled voids in their lives and so many things that takes up the very nature, the core of who they are. And the only thing they have to come to is this. And the only way they have to express themselves when they're coming to this is in a negative, in a dark way. And I don't want to do that. Again, I'm not above that or beyond that. But it's not that important for me to come out of my character, who I am, for the sake of feeding in to demonic forces. Why? For what purpose? I've got enough on me now, even with my father's passing, I still have enough that I have to get together and get done. You know, there are times you have to snap out of it, so to speak, take care of things, and then take a breather and allow yourself to feel and then keep it moving. So I'm not hurt by what you said. I'm not angered by you telling me to get over it. It's just your father, get this, and I was cloud chasing or I'm hating or anything negative that you brought to my attention via YouTube regarding his passing and the things I'm doing afterwards. It didn't work. Go deeper. You've got to go much deeper than that, people from these other channels, whatever, in order to get under my skin. It takes a lot more than that. I've been through a lot. I told you guys, I've been through a lot. So it takes a whole lot more than a lot of people who always just spew out negative and demonic and evil things across YouTube to make me flip. What does it profit a man to gain this whole wide world and in the process lose his soul? I don't want to lose my soul. I have my issues, and I'll always tell you guys this when it comes to religion, even the Bible. But it's still important for me not to lose my soul. And number two, to know that there is a God or there is someone greater than I am who has greater blessings or greater expectations of me and for me. And I'd rather walk in that and stand in that. And whether I see it or not, whether I know it or not, I'd rather just hold on to that, because that's what faith is. Faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. So that's why I want to stand. And that's why I will stand up until my end. I will do that. Just like with my father's end, I did that. But I just wanted you to know, you didn't push a button. You didn't anger me. You only, in so many words, what you did was you solidified what I was shown via the Spirit about you and about the people who are with you and about the people who you're surrounded with. And like I said, I don't think it's a persona for YouTube. I really don't. I think it's who you actually are. I think that's the spirit that you walk in every day of your life. And it's nothing but darkness. And I choose not to do that. I just choose not to walk in darkness. I just don't. So I'm not sure what you were trying to solicit from me. If it was an anger or cussing or yelling. I think it's enough people on YouTube, especially in this particular so-called beef sector, who's doing that, to where I don't have to add to that. And I think there's enough evidence to show what's really the truth behind most of the people on YouTube in general. And I don't have to create a persona, or I don't have to become someone I'm not, or I have to belittle anyone on YouTube in order to either succeed on YouTube or to make myself feel greater or better about myself. It's not that important. It's not that important. The joy of the Lord is my strength. Your prayers, some of you are still praying for me. I thank you. That's getting me through. And then the know that I did the best that I could for my father, that's getting me through. And to some extent, knowing, no, he's not in pain. He's not suffering. And he's not, you know, out of his mind and not knowing what's going on and hurting, the consolation that he's now resting. That gets me going. That gets me through. So say what you want. If anybody said I was scamming them, please let me know how. Like I said, I never mentioned a Cash App. Only reason I did put it there, basically because somebody was asking me, what was my Cash App? They just wanted to send a blessing to me. And before then, you never saw my Cash App. I've never got on here and said anything I mean, anything really just deep, I never did. I posted a picture of my father's, I think, obituary, and that's about it. But the things I've seen most people do on here when it comes to loved ones or something that's going on within their lives, I didn't do that. I didn't come on crying and hollering and, you know, woe is me. I didn't do that. Because it's life, and those things happen in life. And the only thing that bothered me that you would take the time out to come to me and say, get over it. You know, you took something for this and you just using this for cash money. That kind of, excuse my language, pissed me off, because I would never use any member of my family, lie and say they passed or anything or they're sick for the sake of a coin. Mm-mm. And it's not that much of a coin. To where it would really be this big difference in my life. So, no, that's not the case. You choose to live in darkness, you live in darkness. You continue to sow the seed of discord. The Bible speaks on those who do that. And in my case, I just rather allow God to fight my battles. Why should I fight them? What I know was true, and I know what I've given to you on YouTube as far as myself has been true. And I felt better about myself in a lot of ways because I did share and ask part of my life with you. So I don't know what you want out of me. I really don't. But I thank you for leaving the comments. If that's how you feel, then God be with you. God bless you. You know, it's funny, people want to point fingers at, you know, other people when people are scamming you on YouTube. Like I said, I never gave any money to anything dealing with Fication or Clubcation, Club Chatcation, whatever. I've never given any money. Yet these people can come on here and call everybody else liars and scammers when they're doing it right in your faces. And you see it and you know it. Yet for some odd reason, you want to join the bandwagon of saying everybody else is a scammer and a liar and hating and cheating. When it's obvious, it's right there at your faces that's being done. But that's okay. Whatever it takes to get you through the day and get you through the night, then that's what you believe. But again, as I said to you, as I sang to you, I'm good. I have bad days and I have good days. I've got a lot I've got to try to accomplish within so many months, you know. So I'm trying to get all that together by myself. But I thank God for the time I had with my dad, even when he was sick, even he dying in my arms. And when he did die in my arms, he just went to sleep. So I thank God for that moment when I was there with him, when he knew he was not alone and that he knew I was there and that I loved him. I told him that before he, you know, went to sleep. But I'm doing okay. I have my moments. No, I'm not asking for any money. I haven't asked for any. No, I'm not trying to garner sympathy. You know, the passing away of somebody, you know, we all have to go through that, you know, and that's just life. I'm strong now because at this moment I was a little bit miffed at the verbiage someone used regarding my father, regarding the things I put on YouTube. But I had to remind myself, you know, where you are and who you're listening to, and the end results of whatever they were trying to do here on YouTube in the beef sector. But know that I still love you guys. I thank you, Queen Kwani, Rick Reed, James Coldwell. There were some other, so many people I wanted to thank, and I didn't. Lionheart, Tracy, Deanna Irving, so many. Almond Brown, Uncle Tim, just so many people. And if I forget you, please forgive me, because I tried to remember everybody. And hopefully I'll come back and do another video once I get myself situated with some more stuff. But I just needed to come and address that. No, in my own time, I will get over it. Or I won't say get over, but I'll get through it, just like I did with my mom. And whenever the time is, it's God's own timing, not mine. I've tried to place everything in his hands. And at this point, it is all in his hands. And whatever he says, that's his will, that'll be done. Just like anything else in my life or in all of our lives, whatever God's will is, that will be done, okay? Know that I love you, but God loves you so, so, so much more. Please like the video for me. Please subscribe if you haven't. If you want to share, if it's something worth sharing, please share. But I thank you guys so much for all the love and all the prayers and all the support that you've shown me. I love you, but God loves you so much more. You be blessed. Bye-bye.